All right, I'm going to show you some advanced training now, some stuff that I do for stand-up paddle exercises that really has a lot of bleed over into other things, and Arthur's going to lend his expertise as a trainer. I'll show you what I've come up with. The Higante cushion and our mini pro deck or our kicktail. Actually, the kicktail is probably the hardest one because it's the narrowest. The more narrow the board on the Higante cushion, the more difficult it becomes. And we use the cushion with limited air, only about a third full, maybe even a quarter full. If we fill it up more, we lose a bit of that instability. So we're going for max instability here. And we can progress that by using a wider board, the Indo Pro, which, as you see, is much wider, and it compresses the air and makes it more stable. So depending on what level you're at with your stand-up paddling or your training, so let's start with the kettlebell. We're going to do a standard lunge and really testing our balance. And the first thing is to stabilize. And if you look at my feet, you'll see it's anything but stable. The upper body's stable, strong core, great posture, and now dropping into a lunge and up.
So a lot of muscular work happening in the foot and the calf. So the ankle joint getting a lot of motion involved as well.
Okay, and so we want to progress this. Now we'll add resistance on one side. So what is happening now that I've added 18 pounds to this one side, Arthur?
Well, now he's creating a load shift, a distinct load shift to the right side. So now every time you move, it's going to cause him to want to lean towards that right side, which will make him want to naturally compensate by shifting to the left.
Is there anything else I could do with this weight to
make it more challenging?
Yes.
Of course, you can switch hands underneath the leg, underneath the lead leg. And then you can switch back up over across your chest. So you can do what we call a circular switch. So when you're going down into the lunge, you switch under the leg. As you come up, you switch above. So there's a constant variance of loading across the left and right side in a circular pattern.
Well, that's a crazy stuff. We could kind of do some twists. Wow. The instability just gets crazy.
You want to be careful when you're rotating with weight, though, especially when you're on an unstable surface, because the legs are fighting to maintain stability, so it's gonna get a little bit rigid. And so if you're rotating from the upper body, you want to make sure that you're rotating from the T-spine, not rotating from the lumbar, because if you are doing that and your hips are fixated on locking yourself down, that could cause an issue in the lower back.
All right, so we're going to switch decks because that's really hard. We'll go to the Mini Pro, which is a little bit easier. We got a little bit wider stance here. And I can show you with a heavy bar what we're doing with stand-up paddling. So again, stabilizing. Now, a little different than stand-up paddling, my foot is in alignment. So in a proper lunge, you want to have this foot in the same direction as your lead foot. In stand-up paddling, we tend to have that foot in the back across the board, so we got rail-to-rail transition. So a little different, more for function than anything else. Hold the board, the paddle balanced either side. Bring this arm all the way over, hand above the other hand. Top hand above the bottom hand, and try to create a rhythmic paddle type motion. Anything that you can see here?
So what I'm seeing is it's a lot of rotation in the upper body. Upward translation, downward translation through the scapula. So every time he's going from one side to the next, one scap is elevating, turning out, one scap is descending, turning in.
And the key here, again, is we want your eyes to look probably right inside of the elbow and the forearm. So then you know that this hand is across and above the bottom hand. And that's really important because you shorten up the stroke And you make it easier by not reaching all the way over. So doing this doesn't accomplish the instability that you're creating by coming all the way across, which is what a stand-up paddle stroke is like.
He's getting some good movement in his thoracic spine, so he's rotating around his legs. So he's getting rotation in his hips by moving through the upper body.
And then switch stance. Same thing.
And what he can add to make it more difficult, every time you rotate and you paddle to one side, give yourself a little bit of a dip towards the ground, and as you come up to the transition. So what he's doing here is he's adding a split squat to his paddle. So every time he paddles, he dips down. When he comes up, he elevates. When he paddles down, he dips down. And that gives him an initial range of a split squat.
There you go. We could do some stuff parallel. This is a really narrow board. See if we can balance. Anything there?
So you can see that his knees are bowing out a little bit. So he's getting a little bit of varus involved in there. And at times when he's going down, he might get a little bit of valgus in there, which is not bad. As long as it's in control and it's within a comfortable range for his body. So that also includes rotating of the femur and the tibia.
So now I've made it more stable, facing this way. Now this is a stand-up paddle stance as well. But I got much more stability here. So a progression.
Not only that, but you can see where the shift in the board or the deck happens when he changes the direction of his body in relation to the deck. It's now a more forward and backward.
And now I have a wider stance, so my squat is a little.
So when he brings his arm up overhead, what he could be trying to accomplish is to lengthen that extension in the T-spine.
All right, so that's our stand-up paddle exercises. Higante Cushion Mini Pro and Pro Dex along with the Pro Kick Tail.